esteemed top eight, but we're already loading up with our first set here. It's going to be winner's quarters. We're going to have Dany versus UKIT.
Dany and UKIT, this is a matchup I'm excited to see. UKIT coming off of benefiting from a few DQs, but still a very solid player coming in as a 17. Far from out of his element here. Going to be excited to see what he can do against Dany.
So far, already starting off a bit of a, you know, let me feel out my opponent, see what they kind of want to do here. Jigglypuff, obviously a character we don't get to see nearly as often as a character like Wolf. But despite that, so far, things have kind of been moving at a crawling kind of pace. It's kind of weird, actually.
Yeah, UKIT certainly a threat, especially against a fast faller with a poor recovery like Wolf. You never know when a stock can just blow off the board. That shield break almost gave us an early example of that, as the shield pressure onto UKIT barely stays alive, and Dany's playing really safe on these platforms and just abusing Jigglypuff's low mobility.
Yeah, and I mean, especially a character like Wolf into a matchup like Jigglypuff, you're going to want to trade as often as possible because it just means so much more when you get those hits. Already at 91%, we can start fishing for back airs, especially in the corner here, but we'll see if that's going to be the case as UKIT trying to kind of nickel and dime for a couple more hits here. If we can get this Wolf off stage, then maybe, just maybe, we can turn things around.
Yeah, nickel and diming at that low percent kind of is the name of the game of Jigglypuff, because you get yourself in that perfect opportunity to get these setups that he was going for just then. And also that mid percent is where you're getting those platform setups, which Jigglypuff gets a disgusting amount of mileage off of.
Tier 4 tilt is going to be enough, and that is going to be Dany taking the first stock of this game. But honestly, so much time has elapsed, it looks like we're going to be taking a bit more of the scenic route with this matchup.
Yeah, this is very much a matchup with a lot of priority on aerial drift. Both of these characters can drift so quickly and so evasively, it's really hard to pin down both of them. Dany right now doing a good job at doing just that. A couple of aerials in a row. These big hitbox are doing a good job stuffing out UKIT. UKIT's going to chase out, get a dash attack to punish the upbeat, tie up the stock count.
All right, just like that, we have a tied stock count indeed. But 78% is nothing to kind of ignore there, especially on a character like Jigglypuff. So it means that we're going to need a lot more patient, safe gameplay here. And UKIT getting two unanswered down airs there. Those are the kind of interactions you need in order to bring yourself back into this game.
Yeah, Jigglypuff can get a lot of mileage off that down air. So when you don't even get 1 mile, it does not feel great. But already going for that falling up air on the platform, going to trade with Wolf, almost lose that stock. Dany pushing his advantage very strong. The forward air going to chase him way up top. The fair doesn't quite do it. UKIT stays alive.
Okay, now we're at that point where forward tilt definitely in the corner is going to be enough. We'll have to look out for that one. A beautiful air dodge there to avoid the punish, but still so much pressure being put on the UKIT. Needs to find a way in. But look at Dany's moving on the platform. He's going to keep throwing out these nairs coming down, because if they trade, that's going to be the stop.
I really like this kind of platform camping game style that Dany is adopting here. It's really hard for Jigglypuff to get up there and contest it. Wolf says, hey, you want to get up here? I'm going to send you up there with a dash attack, though.
Yeah, that good old soccer kick punting Jigglypuff into the next life. But hold on, we have seen the situation before where UKIT's been behind, forced Dany into the corner, and been able to bring it back to even. Will we see that happen again here?
Yeah, similar percent stack ups that we saw on the first stock. Dany looking to run away with it a little bit more than he could last time. UKIT can't find that nair. That would have been crucial. And now Dany immediately going to bite back. Scratch back, if you will, that Wolf Claw. So dangerous for Jigglypuff. Spaces out so effectively, it's really hard for UKIT to get in. It's been explosive when he has, but that just has not mattered too much so far, as Dany is getting in so consistently.
Man, this is starting to look a little bit rough for UKIT here. Granted, it is game one. You do have quite some time to make the adjustments, as this stock is still on the board here. Was hoping that that back air would be enough, but not quite enough juice to it. The nair sends the opposite direction as well. Just nothing is working out for UKIT right now.
That's the interaction that UKIT has to make the most off of. When Dany's off stage like that, no jump, UKIT needs to be able to close out those stocks, but just barely couldn't catch that one. And that could spell disaster. Now at 100% on his last stock, a Wolf up tilt is going to do it comfortably at that point.
Okay, man. So we're observing a little bit of the struggle right now. UKIT, you know, obviously trying their absolute best to kind of be relevant here, but it's like, I don't know. They're not.
Yeah.
They're trading too often, which never really favors Jigglypuff, let's be honest, right? Like, you're just so light of a character that in situations like that, it's not going to lean in your favor. And then on top of that, it's like, where are the strings? You know what I mean? Like, the stage control seems relatively absent from the matchup thus far for UKIT. Hasn't really been able to control the space that Dany's occupying.
Yeah, speaking of control, Dany has just controlled the pace of the game so effectively. The game has been played at his pace so far. And that is just, like, exactly what Wolf needs to abuse in this matchup is that speed and that jump height and the extra mobility that he has. And right, he's doing that so effectively just as I'm talking, jumping over UKIT, making it really hard for him to keep up, landing ambiguously, and just like racking up percentage.
Okay, let's see a down air. No follow-up. Goes for the grab, but it's on the wrong side. And you can see Dany also leaning into the gun a little bit more here to get, you know, a pot shot here and there. 7, 8% on a character like Jigglypuff matters a lot. We get the edge guard here, and it's going to be some pound to an air dodge, and we are good.
It's a very aware tech there from Dany. You can often get caught off guard by Jigglypuff, but Dany is ready for the tech and has moved accordingly. The up air almost taking the stock 120%. We've seen Jigglypuff die earlier in this matchup. F-Tilt not quite gonna do it. And Wolf's kill moves are just connecting and killing so much earlier than I feel like I'm used to seeing. They're not the most consistent, but against Jigglypuff, they're firing on all cylinders. Speaking of which, that back air from UKIT, it's gonna give him his first lead of the set here.
Yeah, I think the rage assist there definitely playing a little bit of a part of making sure that that KO was a guaranteed knockout. But now we see the down airs. Honestly, these down airs from UKIT have been some of the best pressure tools we've seen in the matchup thus far. And even if he's not getting damped with it, we just drift away. Where's the punish, right? And so definitely trying to lean in and get more of those. But this time gets caught on the jump because you have to do that as Jigglypuff. Buy an up tilt from Dany and things are brought back to even.
Yeah, and those down airs are applying phenomenally safe pressure, but it's not giving UKIT the most in terms of actual damage output. Typically, you see those down airs get a lot of great extensions, but UKIT has not been able to find those, and Dany has been extensions galore. Up throw into a couple of aerials as UKIT gets put up against the back seat here.
Yeah, and I'm just sitting here, and I'm like, this is just funny. We got, like, what is it? Fire Emblem, is it, it's the one Corrin's from, so not three houses. But the music is just kind of sending me right now, bro. It's like, I am the ocean's
so
great waves. And I'm like, we got like a balloon Pokemon and a dog, bro. Like, what is going on
this
here?
This balloon just getting his ass kicked with this like gorgeous choir in the background. Ooh, Dany's going to find another kill confirm. Those have just been firing on all cylinders for him as UKIT is certainly up against the wall, facing the heat. Was off to a great start, but just has not been able to touch Dany since that first stock take about 2 minutes ago.
Okay, maybe, just maybe. Okay, no jab reset on that. I'm thinking, like, on the side of UKIT, I might want to see more pounds, to be honest. Has been able to poke the shield a lot with the down air, right? You're whittling it down. Throwing a pound in there, you might just get an easy shield break.
Yeah, you might just be right. And that's exactly what you're looking for. He answers your call. And this is one thing that UKIT looks for a lot. There's no reason to ever roll in on Jigglypuff. And Dany has been very aware of that. Back air is going to send that game into Danny's favor, 2-0. It's a great start for Dany.
Things are looking kind of rough now, right? I mean, well, not if you're Dany. Dany, things are looking great.
Yeah,
But if you're UKIT, you're kind of like, all right, I got to figure something out here, right? Like, obviously, you know, sticking tried and true to the Jigglypuff here, so it's not going to be a matter of a character swap, but maybe a change of scenery could be what you need. But we see that FD was selected, so I think in the mind of UKIT, it's like, all right, this stage felt like it was working for me. I just wasn't able to execute. Let me run it back and see if I can get it this time.
Yeah, Dany was dominating on platforms, so I do love this pick from UKIT. Jigglypuff does like to get those platform combos and tech chases, but if Dany's just going to be able to out-mobility you the entire time, there's no reason to go to a stage with platforms.
Oof. All right, and already starting off hitting 11%. You can see UKIT trying to hold it down. Nice pound, the delayed hitbox on that. Able to get one and actually forcing Dany to the corner. You need to maintain this positioning. Don't let Dany get center stage, but a trade creates the opening for Dany to go ahead and seize control. And now we can see what happens when Dany has it.
Yeah, Dany with control is a threatening force, as it has been all day, all weekend, and all set so far. Dash attack into up air. He's just not missing these confirms.
Oh man, the nairs yet again, forcing UKIT into the corner. Back air, trades, not what UKIT wants. UKIT can't find the answer. The up air was almost enough there as well. What is UKIT gonna do?
Yeah, disadvantage has been rough. Dany has been all over it. In every facet of the game, Dany is coming out on top right now. UKIT a phenomenal player, but Dany making light work at the moment.
Oh, okay, I like the nair here. Nice grab on the tech as well, this neutral getup rather, but it's still not gonna be enough. You lost stage positioning again. And now Dany can forward tilt, up tilt, up smash. We haven't seen any of those because he hasn't needed to use it. He can throw out back air. Yeah. It's a lot less punishable.
Yeah, there's a lot of things that Wolf has that are gonna be killing right now, 153%. Might even be falling out of F-tilt at this percent. It could be awkward, But UKIT still putting on great pressure, trying to keep it even. But Dany's done a phenomenal job just removing the explosiveness from UKIT's gameplay. Just entirely removing rest kills or ledge guards. UKIT has not been able to find those mid-percentage kills that Jigglypuff needs to find.
Yeah, and I'm wondering if maybe we'll see a little bit more mix-ups with dash attack as well, because UKIT has been jumping quite a bit and has been getting called out by that. Speaking of, another trade in the favor of Dany. I'm thinking, all right, well, if you're being red on your aerial approaches, maybe stay a little bit more grounded. Can we get this edge guard? No! Man, that upward special is just too powerful.
Yeah, Wolf can just trade away in this matchup, and Dany right now finding more trades than a popular pawn shop. He's just giving them all away, and they're all going in his favor. It's a profitable business right now for Dany, as right now we're just playing that neutral game, playing mobility. Dany gets that grab, and that's been the story of the set, is he uses his mobility to condition UKIT into a defensive option and punishes accordingly.
Yeah, and it's tough, right? Because even in a scenario where Jigglypuff is coming down, it's so hard not to get tagged by Wolf, that up air being so hard to work around. There's no aerial Jigglypuff can throw out to just outright stuff it out. And so it's like trying to drift left and right. Can I mix it up? And so far, I mean, UKIT's been trying, but it hasn't been working.
Yeah, nice up tilt. That's going to get it done, even at the stock count. But the best thing Jigglypuff has to contest Wolf in the air is that pound. And it's a rather committal option. So if Dany's able to bait that out, it's a massive punish. So UKIT needs to be careful about the way he's been using it. And he has been, but Dany's just been coming out on top of that. But that's a nice pound to set up a ledge guard potentially. Dany makes it back though.
Okay, great damage, forcing Dany into the corner as well. This is exactly what UKIT needs. Here's a back row. Keep him in the corner, but once again, trying to hit that up special, but just no cigar. It's a tough one to beat out once it's already in motion.
Yeah, Jigglypuff has so many ways to ledge guard. But that Wolf Uppy has just been breaking through it, and the dash attack is going to take the stock. UKIT hasn't been able to find these rests in the corner. Dany's playing so safe around it.
Okay, back row again. Putting Dany in the corner. Tries to go for a ledge jump. Dany immediately picking an option to get back to the stage. It just seems like UKIT has been able to guess right.
The safety of Dany has been the story of this set. UKIT has not been able to catch him biting. He's been playing so, just biding his time, not committing on anything he doesn't need to commit on. And right now we're seeing exactly that. He jumps over the shield, takes center stage. UKIT's able to capitalize though, catch a dash attack with a low recovery. Works out for Dany.
Okay, opts to go off stage. Pretty deep for the edge guard there, but I think Dany kind of saw that one coming, immediately jumped up, did a Wolf Flash, got back onto the stage, but now UKIT has been able to find the stock. It is a final stock scenario. You could bring this to a game number four, but you're at 87% already as Jigglypuff.
As dominant as we've seen Dany, you do never know what can happen as Jigglypuff, right? A lot of rage, you can catch a rest confirmed, you can catch a ledge guard. But Dany has not been doing anything that would make us think that that is what is to come here.
You gotta be careful, you don't wanna come down on top of him. Going sideways seems to be a bit safer here. Hold on, no tech reset. I was hoping we might get a jab or something there, but not gonna see it. That could have been the difference between winning and losing, we'll find out.
Yeah, you can fully committing on that roll in as we see Jigglypuffs do so often. It's such a strong punish if you do find it. Again, it's the safety. Dany just jumping around, looking for any mistake that UKIT can possibly make. UKIT trying his best not to make one, but he does. He slips up just slightly, and Dany, a shark that smells blood in the water, pursuing forward, falling there, not going to connect.
All right, what is going to be the option here for UKIT? Understanding that pretty much any hit at this point will lead to a knockout, so has to be extremely careful in the way in which they decide to approach. No punish on that dash attack, but it is a tricky one. We get the down air into the grab, forcing Dany into the corner. Can we clutch up?
This is a spot to clutch up if you're UKIT stuck in the corner, but he gets tagged with the dash attack. UKIT surging back at the very end, but in the end, it was Dany who took it.
Just a little bit too late. That is going to be how the cookie crumbles. But Dany, on the other side of things, extremely happy with that one. That means that's going to be a nice little winner's comfy spot in the top eight side of things. So you know he got to be happy. But on the other side, UKIT, we will probably end up catching a little bit later on the elimination side of bracket to see if maybe he can qualify through the loser side.
Yeah, I don't predict this being the last we see of UKIT, right? He's on a great run. We are in top 16. He is the 17 seed, but he's been moving phenomenally today. And yesterday, he's been doing great this whole tournament. So keep an eye out for UKIT as we move forward into Anthony Isn't Cool versus Tim Prater.